communicates to me, so that's why I'm coming to ask. If it's something to copy, and you can tell that you've copied it correctly because you get a little blinking line around the cells. But I was watching a colleague from the US do a similar demo to this, and he called it a marching ant. Can you imagine ants marching around those cells? I've got the marching ants, so they're doing copy. Go back to Word. I want to keep that information into Word. And at this stage, you think to yourself, is it going to retain the original format system from that cell or not? How's it going to look? Just place your bets now. You've got no idea. And this is really a gamble in the past, but you need to keep playing and offers. It's the ability to preview all the possible case outcomes to point to it. So, I can just create a link back to the original data that you just have saved where I can table and display the text. But the one I want for this one is if that one has changed that original format, and I think that is definitely in Excel. Okay, this is going to the end of this document, so I've got a few tips and tricks up my sleeve. These are useful for any version of Word, so not unique to the latest version, not the same as Word. But I'm a great fan of keyboard shortcuts for speeding up the way you work. So if you do like the idea of learning some keyboard shortcuts, so just do a search for Word or Excel keyboard shortcuts, you'll get the way to do it. These are my own personal labels. So, look at this table. The second table in the row, the fourth row, I want to move to the top of the table. Now, I'm sure some of you have been doing that one.
Control square bracket.
One of the square brackets goes one way, one square bracket.